Hi, good day. So for today, we are going to talk about the solubility product constant. The solubility product constant, which is symbolized as KSP, is a numerical value which tells us the extent on which a salt or any ionic compounds will dissolve or dissociate in water. It is like the dissociation constant for acid or the dissociation constant for base, but this one is apparently the dissociation constant for salts or any ionic compounds. Also, solubility product constant tells us the salt solubility or the solubility of any ionic compounds in water. Here, higher KSP or higher solubility product constant means more soluble in water. Now take note that each ionic compound has their own KSP or solubility product constant. For example, if we are going to get the solubility product constant of silver chloride, which is 1.8 times 10 raised to negative 10, and compare it to the solubility product constant of silver cyanide, which is 2.2 times 10 raised to negative 16, then we will actually know that silver chloride is more soluble in water than silver cyanide, since it has higher KSP or solubility product constant than silver cyanide. Now, there are some salts or ionic compounds that once they are dissolved in water, they dissociate into their ionic forms. But the dissociated ions recombine to reform the original salts or ionic compounds. This makes them insoluble in water. Take lead-2-fluoride as an example. When lead-2-fluoride is dissolved in water, it dissociates into positively charged lead ion and negatively charged fluoride ion. Now, these two ions here, the lead ion and the fluoride ion, recombine to reform the lead-2-fluoride. Now, take note that this dissociation is a reversible dissociation. And there will be a point that the rate of the formation of lead ion and fluoride ion will be as fast as the rate of formation of lead-2-fluoride. That point is known as the equilibrium point. The solubility product constant also tells us the equilibrium point in a dissociation. Also, solubility product constant tells us the saturation point of any ionic compounds or any salts. Saturation point is actually the limit to which a salt or ionic compound can be dissolved in water. Now, how do we express the formula for solubility product constant? The formula for solubility product constant follows the format A sub N, B sub M is equal to the molar concentration of the cation raised to N multiplied to the molar concentration of the anion raised to M, wherein our A sub N, B sub M here is the salt or ionic compound. A is actually the cation, B is the anion, and N and M here represent the stoichiometric coefficients of these ions. To give you an example, let's have here the calcium phosphate. When calcium phosphate is dissolved in water, it dissociates into 3 particles of calcium ion and 2 particles of phosphate ion. Now, these 3 here came from the subscript of calcium in calcium phosphate formula, and our 2 here came from the subscript of phosphate ion in calcium phosphate formula. Therefore, if you are going to express the formula for its solubility product constant, then we will have here KSP, or the solubility product constant of calcium phosphate, is equal to the molar concentration of the cation. In this case, our cation is calcium. Okay? And its stoichiometric coefficient is 3. Therefore, it will now be raised to 3, or to the third power, multiplied to the molar concentration of the phosphate ion, which is actually our anion here, raised to the second power. Second power because its stoichiometric coefficient is 2. Okay? Now, in reality, the solubility product constant of calcium phosphate is 1.2 times 10 raised to negative 29 molar raised to the fifth power. Now, take note that this number came from the product of the molar concentration of the calcium ion raised to the third power and the molar concentration of phosphate ion raised to the second power in calcium phosphate. And our unit here would be molar concentration raised to the fifth power, and this fifth power came from the sum of this one, 3 And 2, 3 plus 2 is equal to 5. Therefore, its unit is actually molar raised to the 5th power. Now, there are 4 major factors that can affect the solubility or the dissociation of a salt or any ionic compound. These are the temperature, pressure, concentration, and acidity and basicity. For the first 2 factors, let's have here the temperature and pressure. Our trend here will be as temperature or pressure increases, the solubility of a salt or any ionic compound also increases. This can actually be explained through Le Chatelier principle. Now, if you are not yet familiar with Le Chatelier principle, might as well watch my video about Le Chatelier principle, and the link for that video is on the description box below. Okay, now, let's give here an example. Let's take calcium phosphate again. When calcium phosphate is dissolved in water, it dissociates into calcium ion and phosphate ion. Now, as we increase the temperature or pressure in this system, okay, the one that will originally experience that increase in temperature would be this side of this equation. Okay? Now, remember, according to Le Chatelier principle, one of our causes of stress is the raise in temperature or raise in pressure, or increase in temperature or increase in pressure. Now, because this one experienced an increase in temperature, then this one is more stressed. This side of the equation is more stressed than this side of the equation. And again, according to Le Chatelier principle, the side with less stress applied will be favored more in product formation than the side with more stress applied. In this case, this one is more stressed than this side because of the increase in temperature or pressure. And because of that, more calcium ion and phosphate ion will dissociate from calcium phosphate. Okay, therefore, increasing the solubility of calcium phosphate. For the third factor, let's have here the concentration. Here, our trend would be as the concentration of the dissociated ions increases, the solubility of the salt decreases. That can still be explained through Le Chatelier principle and common ion effect. Now, let's give here an example. Let's take again the calcium phosphate. When calcium phosphate is dissolved in water, it dissociates into positively charged calcium ion and negatively charged phosphate ion. Okay. Now, let's see, for example, we added sodium phosphate in this equation. Okay. We added sodium phosphate in this salt. Now, this sodium phosphate will also release phosphate ion. And as we have noticed in this equation, phosphate ion can be found in this side, in the right side of this equation. Now, again, according to Le Chatelier principle, one of the causes of stress in an equation or in a solution is the addition or increase in concentration. In this case, we actually increased the concentration of phosphate ion. We actually added more phosphate ion, and these phosphate ions that we actually added came from the sodium phosphate. Now, because of that, this side of the equation, the right side of the equation, is more stressed than this side of this equation. And according to Le Chatelier principle, the product formation will be more favored in that side with less stress than that side with more stress. In this case, this side is less stressed than this side of the equation, and therefore, the product formation will be more favored in this side of the equation than this side of the equation. Okay? And that means less salt will dissociate to become calcium ion and phosphate ion, but instead, more calcium ion and phosphate ion will recombine to form or to reform a calcium phosphate compound. And for the last factor, let's have here the acidity and basicity. Addition of acid or base in a salt solution may increase or decrease the solubility of a salt. Specifically, basic salts are more soluble in acidic solution, while acidic salts are more soluble in basic solution. Now, take note that the solubility of a neutral salt is not affected by an addition of acid or base. Now, if you're not yet familiar with the type of salts, might as well watch my video about the type of salts, and the link for that video is on the description box below. So those are the things that you need to know about the solubility product constant. Thank you for listening, and good day.